I'm very happy to be hosting Dr. Javier Ruiz Perez to discuss his recent PLOS ONE Lab Protocol paper entitled Reproducible Protocol for the Extraction and Semi-Automated Quantification of Macroscopic Charcoal from Soil and the Associated Detailed Protocol in Protocols.io. Dr. Ruiz Perez is a postdoctoral researcher, research associate in the Texas A&M University Department of Ecology and Conservation Biology. He's an archaeologist and paleoecologist with field experience in Spain, India, Brazil, and Bolivia. His research is mostly focused on tropical South America, where he uses plant remains to analyze past fire vegetation and human-environment relationships. Currently, he's studying the millennial scale role of fire in shaping tropical forest savanna mosaics by conducting field research in the eastern lowlands of Bolivia. Throughout his career, Dr. Ruiz Perez has secured funding for his research activities, including a grant awarded by the National Geographic Society, and has participated in different international projects, leading to publications in journals such as Global and Planetary Change, PLOS ONE, and Nature. He is an executive committee member of the Texas A&M University Postdoctoral Association, as well as a member of the International Committee on Open Phytolith Science and the International Committee on Phytolith Morphometry at the International Phytolith Society. Javier, thank you so much for talking to me.
Thank you for having me today.
So to kick off, can you briefly explain what the protocol is about, how to use it, and why it is relevant?
Our protocol is a detailed and step-by-step guide for the extraction and semi-automated counting and measurement of charcoal fragments from soil samples. So the protocol consists of two major phases. One is the extraction of the charcoal from the soil sample, and the other one is the quantification. So the first phase involves the dispersion and digestion of soil using some chemicals, washing the sample through a sieve, and then the isolation and collection of the charcoal fragments. And the quantification involves the taking microscope images of the charcoal fragments, and then using an image J macro code that we provide with the protocol that will automatically count and measure the area, length, and width of these charcoal fragments. I think this protocol is relevant for experienced, but also junior scientists interested in studying charcoal fragments to reconstruct past fires. So after a fire, when the plant dies, it releases charcoal that incorporates into soils and sediments, and that they can persist for millions, well, usually thousands, but sometimes millions of years in these soils and sediments. And we can then quantify them, identify them, and date them to reconstruct fire histories.
And to understand the significance of your method, can you please tell us a little bit about what was the state of the art at the moment? So what was your motivation to optimize this method, and why previously published methods, if any, weren't good for your purposes?
So there are different reasons. The main one is that most protocols available in the field, they're designed for charcoal from lake sediments. And to our knowledge, there are no detailed protocols for the extraction and quantification of macro charcoal from soil samples. And also, we did an assessment of publications containing charcoal data, and we learned that most of them, they don't make the methods available. So we wanted to provide to the community a protocol with enough details to make a protocol reproducible. And finally, also the script we wrote for the image processing software, ImageJ, it's kind of new in the sense that it will batch process the images automatically, and it will quantify the charcoal in a way that it's user-friendly, because it will generate an interface and you don't need to mess around with the code to make it work and use the different functions of the code. I would say these are the main reasons.
And now going deeper in the protocol itself, what would you say are the most critical steps?
Well, as I say, the protocol consists of two major phases: the extraction of charcoal from soil samples and the semi-automated quantification. So I think every step in both phases is crucial to obtain reliable results. But if I have to highlight two of them, I would say that, first of all, charcoal is very fragile. So you have to take care of the soil samples and then the isolated charcoal fragments, not to break them or damage them while you're handling them. And also, it's very important to collect high quality microscope images to get accurate results with the image macro code. So that means that the images, they have to use the same microscope and camera settings for all the images. And also the charcoal fragments, they have to be properly separated from each other and distinguishable from the background.
As you were developing the protocol, both, you know, the hands-on experimental part and the computational analytical part, was there anything that you tried in either of those sections that didn't work and didn't make it to the final version of the protocol?
Well, we work with different versions of the image code, and until we get a version that works, that performs properly in a reliable and fast way. So I guess that there are a lot of lines of code that they didn't make it to the final version of the code. Yeah.
And what about the first part, the collection of the charcoals?
It was quite straightforward, I would say, because the literature is more available on that aspect of the protocol. So I just had to adapt it a bit for soil samples.
And I know that the protocol and the publication are relatively young. You just published them during the summer of this year, but I wonder whether you have made any further optimizations since the time of publication.
No, we haven't made any modifications to the protocol yet, but we're open to receive some feedback from our colleagues from the field. And also, we're also open to make any adjustments once we start using the protocol in future studies.
And do you think that the protocol can be applied or extended to many different types of soil?
Yes, I think so. Yes, so we tested the protocol using samples from tropical Bolivia. They contain high volumes of organic matter and clays, but I'm sure that the protocol can be used in different types of soils as long as the chemical solution we use to disperse and digest the soils work. Otherwise, the users will have to adapt the volume of the chemicals they need to use to get clean extractions.
So do you think that a step, the chemical solution of the soil, is a step that other researchers will have to tweak if they want to transfer your protocol to a different to a soil of a different nature?
Yes, that's something they should try ideally, just to see if the solution that we are recommending works for them. So they have to make sure that it won't damage the charcoal, and also they will get clean extractions. Like,
so
I mean, charcoal without soil attached to it.
I would like us to change gears a little bit now and talk about your motivation to have this protocol peer-reviewed as a standalone methodological paper in PLOS ONE.
So we wanted to publish the protocol along with the paper for different reasons. The first one, I would say, it's that we wanted to give some context to the protocol and show what's our contribution to the field. So what's new, what we're adding to the existing protocols in the literature. Another reason is that it gave us the opportunity to show the kind of data that the protocol produces once you use it. And finally, it also allowed us to provide an assessment of the quality of the charcoal extractions and also a validation of the IMAGE code against manual measurements.
And how did the feedback that you received from the peer reviewers shape the final version of the protocol?
Well, we received positive feedback from three reviewers, which helped us improve the clarity of the protocol, I would say. So they helped us to adjust some steps and make them more clear.
As mentioned previously, this is a young protocol. So the next question might be a little bit speculative at this time, but how do you see this protocol impacting your career as a young researcher?
Well, I think developing the protocol and publishing the paper improved my understanding of charcoal research. And also, as I was saying, it allowed me to make my own and humble contribution to the field. And also, I think the protocol shows my commitment to the open science principles, because one of the reasons why I wanted to publish the protocol and the paper was to promote the standardization and reproducibility of charcoal methods.
Javier, I don't have any more questions at the moment. I don't know if you want to add anything that hasn't been touched in this conversation.
I don't have anything else to say. I would just encourage any user who has any questions to just contact me, and I'll be happy to help them use the protocol with their own samples.
Thank you, Javier.
Thank you.